of three of the most popular superstars in the history of OVW. The thrill seeker from San Diego, Johnny Cheater. The seven footer from Connecticut, Matt Morgan. And the ex-OVW heavyweight champion, Mr. Wrestling, Nick Dinsmore. You did something not very easy to do. You gained the respect of Kane, a former WWF champion. He said it would be a pleasure to team with you or to face you one day at WrestleMania. And of course, last week, you helped out Bradshaw when he needed a helping hand. Well, on Saturday night, May 10th, at Western High School, there's somebody else that needs to be put in their place. You, Johnny Cheater, and Nick Dinsmore are going to go 3-on-3 in a six-man tag with the Revolution. Your thoughts on the big Western High Havoc event?
Well, Jimmy, I've been here in OVW now for a good year. And sitting back in that locker room week after week after week, I've seen the same old thing. Whether it's Bowling Services, the Disciples of Sin, and even more importantly, the Revolution, they've all done one thing, and they've done it well. And that's cheap. Week after week. See, they have strength in numbers. And all they do is gang up on whoever their opponent is, and that's how they win half of their damn victories. I'm here tonight to tell you, Revolution, Doug, Rob, damage up. Those days are numbered. Because my buddy's here, Nick Dinsmore, the thrill seeker, Johnny Jeter. Have acquired the services of 1 7-foot, 330-round monster who will not only even the odds, Revolution, but will make sure it's a night you won't forget.
Well, that's Saturday night, May 10th at Western High School here in Louisville. But Johnny Cheater, a young man that's come a long way in a short period of time, and I'll tell you something, Johnny, when you win big. Everybody knows the upset victory that puts you on the map was a victory over Canyon, a former U.S. champion. In the process, you made a bitter enemy out of Canyon. Well, at Six Flags Spring Breakout, just 2 weeks ago, you defeated the current OVW champion Machine in the deciding fall of the Ironman match to win for your team. And I think he deserves a round of applause for that. And so I'm here to announce that on Friday night, May 30th, when the Summer Sizzler Series at Six Flags kicks off, Johnny, Machine is embarrassed about the situation. Canyon still wants a piece of you. I know the feeling is mutual. It's going to be Machine and Canyon at Six Flags May 30th against you, and your partner will be none other than one of the biggest stars in this industry. Big Papa Pump, Scott Steiner. Steiner and Cheater against Machine and Canyon at Six Flags on May 30th.
You know, Jimmy, I've been a star believer. You can't win if you don't try. I knew Canyon was a veteran. I knew he was a former U.S. champion, but I beat him because I didn't back down. Doug Basham, OVW heavyweight champion. I beat him too because I didn't back down. Now, Canyon and Basham, anyone will tell you, man, put them together, they're nothing but trouble. But I got the big bad booty daddy, Big Papa Pump, in my corner. Six Flags May 30th.
Well, I'll tell you what, Johnny, congratulations. It's going to be a great opportunity for you, but there's one more gentleman that we have not spoken to. And Nick, I know it's been a rough, an up and down, a roller coaster few weeks. You won the Ironman match at Six Flags, but it was after you had lost the OVW title in that classic to Machine. You blame Rob Conway, and I think rightfully so. If Conway's loaded glove had not been in the ring during that title match, then you would very well still be the OVW champion. Therefore, as a co-main event, Friday night, May 30th, the Summer Sizzler Series, Six Flags, Kentucky Kingdom, you one-on-one with the Iron Man, Rob Conway. However, that's not all. A special stipulation that you've demanded, it's going to be a coal miner's glove match. There'll be a loaded glove placed on a 15-foot pole in the corner of the ring. Whoever gets it first can use it any way they like, and I know you're thinking about payback and retribution.
You know, Jimmy, it's been killing me that Rob Conway cut a fall on me at the spring breakout. But what's been killing me even worse is that every time I go to get my hands on him, ever since he turned on me right here at TV a couple months ago, is that every time I try to get my hands on him, Doug Basham with the damage is there to beat me from behind. Well, Conway, come May 30th, it's not about the revolution. It's about a 15-foot high steel pole. It's not about the German suplex. It's not about the crippler crossface. It's not about your ego trip. It's about a coal miner's glove on a pole. And the first person that get it can beat the other one senseless. And you better believe that that person is going to be me. But Jimmy, that's not all. You're talking about the Super Summer Sizzler Series? You're talking about Six Flags? I love going to Six Flags. They've got games there. They've got water slides. They've got the Tunnel of Love. But most of all, my favorite, they have roller coasters. They've got fast roller coasters. They make you do loop-de-loops, forwards, backwards, upside down. They'll take you from 0 to 80 in a blink of an eye. Whenever you get off these roller coasters, your stomach's kind of churning, your heart's beating, you're sweating a little bit, and you feel like you might even lose your lunch. Well, I guarantee you one thing, is that you have to pay money to get on these rides in this park. And Rob Conway, come May 30th, I've got a ticket for you. Why don't you take a ride on the franchise? We might slow down, but we sure as hell aren't going to stop. And Conway, I do guarantee you this, you are going to pay, and you are going to pay dearly. Because when you get off this ride, you're not only going to lose your lunch, but you might lose a couple teeth.
Well, there you have it. Coal Miner's Glove, Dinsmore and Conway. It's all part of Six Flags. We're going to be back with a tug-of-war challenge.